Today we tell the story of Bob Hope. He was one of the world's most famous comedians. His life in show business lasted for more than 70 years.
Bob Hope was born in Eltham, England, in 1903. His parents named him Leslie Towns Hope. Many years later, he began calling himself Bob. Leslie was the fifth of seven sons. He and his family moved to the United States in 1907. They settled in the city of Cleveland, Ohio. Leslie's mother taught him how to sing. As a child, he had a good singing voice. Later in life, Bob Hope often said he never wanted to be anything but a funny man. Leslie attended Cleveland public schools. He sold newspapers and worked for a meat market and a shoe store. After high school, he learned how to dance. He also showed an interest in the sport of boxing.
When Bob Hope was 18 years old, he asked his girlfriend to become his dance partner. They began appearing at local vaudeville theaters. Vaudeville was the most popular form of entertainment in the United States in the early 1900s. Vaudeville shows presented short plays, singers, dancers, comedians telling jokes, and other acts. Bob Hope's dance act with his girlfriend did not last long. A short time later, he heard that a Cleveland theater needed performers for a show with the famous actor Fatty Arbuckle. Hope developed a dance act with another friend, and they were chosen for the show. The team performed briefly as part of Arbuckle's traveling vaudeville show.
Later, Hope formed a song and dance team with George Byrne. They performed at theaters across the United States. The two men were offered work in a show on Broadway in New York City, but they did not stay very long. They left New York to change their act and start over again. They performed at a small theater in Pennsylvania. On opening night, Hope was asked to tell the crowd about future shows at the theater. The people liked the way he sounded. So did the supervisor of the theater. Hope then expanded his announcement to 5 minutes. Bob Hope started to perform by himself. He became skilled at standing in front of crowds and telling jokes, often very quickly. He collected jokes and told them during his performances. Hope did not wear special clothing or use tricks when performing, but he made funny expressions with his face to make people laugh.
Bob Hope returned to Broadway in the 1930s. Theater critics and the public liked his performance in the musical Roberta. The show changed his life in more than one way. One day, another performer took Hope to meet a young singer who was also working in New York. Her name was Dolores Reed. She and Hope married in 1934. They would stay together as husband and wife for the next 69 years. After the musical Roberta, Bob Hope performed in a number of other Broadway shows. They included Ziegfeld Follies and Red, Hot, and Blue. Hope's acting success led to his first major film, The Big Broadcast of 1938. In the film, he and Shirley Ross sang a song called Thanks for the Memory. Many people think of Bob Hope when they hear this song.
Thanks for the memory of sentimental verse. Nothing in my purse, and chuckles when the preacher said, for better or for worse. How lovely it was. Thanks for the memory of Schubert's serenade, little things of jade, and traffic jams and anagrams and bills we never paid. How lovely it was.
In 1937, Bob Hope agreed to do a series of radio programs called The Woodbury Soap Show. The next year, he agreed to do a radio show for another company that made Pepsodent toothpaste. His Tuesday night radio show soon became popular. Hope continued doing radio shows for almost 20 years. His success in radio led to a long-term relationship with a major film company, Paramount Pictures. The actors who worked in Hope's films also made appearances on his radio shows. In all, Hope was the lead actor in more than 50 films. He also had small parts in 15 others. Bob Hope never won an Academy Award for his acting. However, the American film industry did honor him 5 times. His series of films with actress Dorothy L'Amour and singer Bing Crosby became world famous. Hope and Crosby were close friends. Here, they sing a song from the movie The Road to Morocco.
On the road to Morocco, this camel is tough on the spine.
Hit me with a band-aid, Dad.
Where they're going, why we're going, how can we be sure?
I'll lay you 8 to 5 that we'll meet Dorothy L'Amour.
And get in line.
Off on the road to Morocco, hang on till the end of the line.
Like your jacket.
Quiet, I hear this country's where they do the dance of the seven veils.
We tell you more, we would have the censor on our tail.
Good boy.
We certainly do get around. Like Webster's Dictionary, we're Morocco bound.
Bob Hope began performing on television in 1950. He made a special program for NBC television. His show included a famous personality, a singer, and a beautiful young woman. Hope used this successful combination again and again. He decided to avoid all the work involved with a weekly television show. However, he continued making television specials every year until 1995.
For more than 50 years, Bob Hope traveled around the world giving shows for members of America's armed forces. It started in 1941 when he and several other performers went to an airbase in California. Later that year, the United States entered World War II after Japanese forces attacked the American naval base at Pearl Harbor, Hawaii. Hope attempted to join the armed forces. He was told he could better serve his country as a performer, building support for the war effort. So he took a team of performers to bases around the country to perform his radio show.
Hope and his team performed for millions of soldiers during World War II. He performed almost all of his shows at bases across the United States, Europe, and the South Pacific. Listen now to part of a show broadcast to soldiers after the war had ended.
How do you do, ladies and gentlemen? This is Bob broadcasting for future civilians at the Santa Ana Separation Center, California Hope. Well, here we are. Here we are at Santa Ana. In just 3 days, these fellas will have their discharge. A discharge. That's a little piece of paper that changes the lieutenant's name from Sir to Stinky.
Hope began what was to become a Christmas tradition in 1948. That is when he and his wife went to Germany to perform for troops involved in the Berlin airlift. Later, he performed for American soldiers serving in South Korea, Vietnam, and Lebanon. In 1990, Hope and his wife performed for troops in Saudi Arabia. At the time, he was 87 years old.
Bob Hope was a friend to many American presidents. He played golf with Dwight Eisenhower, Richard Nixon, Gerald Ford, and George Bush. Several presidents also honored the famous comedian. President John Kennedy gave Hope the Congressional Gold Medal. President Lyndon Johnson presented him with the Medal of Freedom. United States Congress honored Hope 4 times. In 1997, Congress made him an honorary veteran of the armed forces. He was the first individual so honored in American history. The following year, Britain's Queen Elizabeth made Hope an honorary knight. She recognized his work in films and his service to Allied forces during World War II.
People in many countries celebrated Bob Hope's birthday on May 29, 2003. He was 100 years old. The celebrations included the naming of a famous area in Hollywood, California, as Bob Hope Square. Sadly, Hope was too weak to attend. 2 months later, he became sick and developed pneumonia. Bob Hope died at his California home on July 27, 2003.